Hey everybody, this is Brandon. I brought along Jeff. We're going to talk about XCOM Enemy Within.
Ayo, what was the other one called? Enemy Without?
Unknown.
Enemy Unknown. So we know who the enemy is now.
They are within.
They are within. Are they really? Within.
Yes, because you actually take, like after you autopsy and interrogate these aliens, you gain abilities that you can then modify your soldiers with.
Oh, really? So we can use the alien technology against them?
Correct.
A lot of people don't know this, but in the 70s, that's how we beat a real alien invasion, was we stole their Velcro technology and used it against them.
That makes perfect sense, actually.
Yep.
It's kind of strange how it does. But Enemy Unknown was a... Enemy Unknown was a fantastic game that was released last year, I believe.
Uh-huh. Sure, if you say
and... so. Yeah, sure, why not? And Enemy Within is pretty much an expansion pack in the old school sense. Not really DLC. So
like
this has
Brood
a ton
War.
Of, yeah, like a Brood
That's
War.
That's the first expansion pack that came to mind. I don't know why.
Well, it was a good one, at least.
Yeah, it was great.
If that's your thing.
How does this game compare to StarCraft?
Entirely different.
Really? You see no similarities. I can give you one big one right now that you're totally skipping over. Aliens. Both prominently featured in both games.
Yeah, you... Fuck, you got me.
Guns.
And the fact that the chrysalids kind of look like Zergs.
Yep, there you go.
Damn
Physical
it.
Physical similarities.
Fuck.
Top down. Characters.
Well, yeah,
Humans.
They both have characters in them, Jeff. You've got a very solid point.
Yeah. Let's not forget about the humans.
Oh, there is some humans in this game.
Yeah,
I completely forgot about that.
God, come on, man. You got to learn your shit.
We might as well start over now. God damn it.
All right, so Enemy Within is in every respect of or spiritually a expansion pack, very similar to Brood War, from what I understand, and it's basically the same game collecting all of the different DLCs, and then smashes them all together, and then totally different achievements that are all tied to the new game mechanics, which
are not
from the DLCs, but are an addition
correct.
To this game.
Fuck, they are
smart. I got all that from listening to you.
I know. You've actually paid attention. I'm actually surprised you actually pay attention when I talked. What ends up, this game is just like a behemoth now. There's so fucking much in this game.
The behemoth made Castle Crashers, which is not any, I would assume, nothing like this game.
Correct.
All right.
Nothing at all.
Making sure we're clear there. So this game is like the behemoth.
Yes.
A game that makes arcade games, or a company that makes arcade games.
Which are all really good.
Yeah, they're great. My daughter has a behemoth t-shirt. Just throwing that out there. Yeah.
Just tossing that one out there.
Yeah.
But onto the actual game itself.
Is it a hot dog
itself.
Or a skateboard is what the t-shirt says. You have to check with like a Sharpie.
Okay. This game, tons of shit.
Okay.
This feels like the sixth time I've said something like that. It's weird.
Yeah.
Strange. Just 45 new maps so
that
you don't see anything new.
Let me ask you a question.
Sure.
What is your favorite Behemoth game?
Probably Castle Crashers.
Castle Crashers? A lot of people like that game.
Yeah. Maw's
Two
really good,
shitty,
and so...
shitty, shitty multiplayer achievements. Very hard to get.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the Maw is still really good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, are we going to talk about XCOM, or do we have to talk about Castle Crashers the whole time?
Well, I guess we could talk about XCOM if that's what you want to
do. Let's
do
it. Okay. Yeah, let's do it.
So, XCOM. You can now cut your soldiers' arms off and legs off and put them in mech suits.
Okay, seriously? They can't just they can't build a suit with enough room to put an entire human in?
You have to cut their limbs off.
And that's an add-on from Enemy Without? Enemy Unknown.
Yes, that is. And that's actually one of the achievements in the game, is to augment a soldier. Which is why the name of that achievement is Who Needs Limbs?
By saying augmenting a soldier, that's a really nice way of saying decapitate.
Well, you're not decapitating them, but as they do say in the actual game, requisite amputations.
Ugh. All right, fine.
Yeah. And then you also gene mod people, which is the other coin of that, and once you do one, you can't do the other to the same soldier. And then each of those have their own small little achievements tied to them, and eventually in the game, you actually will get assaulted by aliens, which was something that a lot of the old school XCOM people weren't a big fan of that was not in this game, was the base defense.
Uh-huh.
So now we have it. Yes.
Maybe
and it's actually pretty neat.
Up.
I haven't gotten to it yet, but I've seen some footage of it. It's really cool.
Cool.
And
thank God they added it.
I know, because people wouldn't shut up about it. But other than
hey, are you aware of the achievement They Shall Not Pass for 20 Gamer Score? Eliminate all alien waves. Sweet Lord of the Rings reference there.
And it's also part of that base defense.
Yeah, there you go. It's all coming together. Did you know that I am, as we speak, reading Fellowship of the Ring to my daughter and reading Game of Thrones? It's weird to read both of those books at the same time.
Yeah, they're kind of...
game-changing epic fantasy series.
Yeah, they're kind of like two sides of the same epic fantasy.
Yeah,
weird.
Pretty much. Lord of the Rings is a lot more boring than Game of Thrones. Not nearly as much fucking.
Yeah, there's a little less fucking and decapitations in Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
Just a tiny bit less. But other than that, yeah, sure.
Yeah.
We have some stuff with this new Cerberus-type group called Exalt in the game, where you got to snipe people and make medics explode.
Okay.
Which is our fun stuff.
Explode medics,
and then
sure.
There's a whole bunch that are tied to having a squad and beating a mission with people that are gene-modded or in mech suits.
Okay.
Which is what those four are. And there's only one beat the game achievement this time, as opposed to like six in the original game.
Well, I guess they figured you've already beaten the game if you played Enemy Outside, and there's no reason to make you play this one four or five more times.
Correct. So you just got to beat the game without getting a squad size upgrade on Classic or Impossible difficulty.
Okay. Is that hard?
Yes.
Have you done it yet?
I haven't done it yet.
Are you going to do it?
Yes.
All right.
I plan on it.
You should probably do that.
I should. Maybe be able to put on the Iron Man difficulty, too.
Let me ask you a question.
Sure.
If I were to have a copy of Enemy Outside and Enemy Inside, or Within, on my desk mm-hmm. right now, which one should I play?
Enemy Within. Because it is Enemy Unknown, but better.
But better. It's like Enemy Unknown X.
Correct.
All right. Got it.
There you go. Maybe. Play that one. All right. It's good times.
Thank you.
Pretty fantastic.
It's been a very informative video.
Yes, about random-ass things, a little bit of XCOM, and a little bit about Lord of the Rings.
I feel like we learned a little bit about each other, too.
I know. It's kind of weird.
Yeah. Cheap Hunter out. Yeah.